Hello, I'm Johara Singaporensis, a Singapore freshwater crab, but you can just call me Jo. And I want to tell you about some magical forests called mangroves. In this video, I want to talk about protecting our mangroves. As an endangered species of crab on the brink of extinction, I know just how important it is to feel safe and protected. My friend, Max the mangrove tree, lives in a mangrove forest in Sungai Buloh Wetland Reserve. Max is now protected, but life wasn't always so sweet for Singapore's mangroves. Cleared for development, agriculture and aquaculture, by the mid-1980s, most of the mangroves of Sungai Buloh had vanished. It wasn't until 1986 that nature lovers noticed that Sungai Buloh was a major stopover for flocks of migrating birds and persuaded the government to open a nature park, which is now managed by the National Parks Board. Sadly, even after all this effort, less than 5% of Singapore's original mangroves remain. Protection alone isn't enough. We also need to make more mangroves. But planting, growing, and restoring mangroves isn't easy. While Max and the mangroves are tough and sturdy and can survive in very harsh conditions, they're also quite sensitive and delicate. Restoration or bringing mangroves back is also tricky because Max and the mangroves are rather fussy. Mini-Max mangrove seedlings, known as propagules, settle and grow easily in suitable soil. But the conditions have to be just right. The water level mustn't be too shallow or too deep. The water flow mustn't be too fast or too slow. Anything less than perfect conditions, and the mangrove seedlings simply won't grow. Unsurprisingly, the success rate for mangrove planting and restoration is very low. But in Pulau Ubin off Singapore's northern coast, they've started a restoration project that's beginning to work. The Restore Ubin Mangroves Initiative, known as RUM, is letting Mother Nature do the planting. Officially called ecological mangrove restoration, it means that instead of just simply planting mangroves anywhere there's some space, conservationists are studying the existing mangroves very carefully. They're watching whether different species of mangrove seedlings settle and grow naturally, learning about the water flow that distributes the mangrove seedlings, and then creating the ideal conditions for mangroves to grow themselves. This natural approach to restoring mangroves has been so successful that there are now plans for thousands of mangrove plants to naturally take root on the site of abandoned aquaculture ponds at Sungai Durian in Pulau Ubin. As Max and the mangroves are so sensitive, slow to grow, and difficult to restore, you might wonder why conservationists devote so much time, energy, and money to making more mangroves. The answer is simple. Mangroves are so important to the future of people and the planet that we must protect them. Most importantly, mangroves are a natural major store of carbon, which scientists call blue carbon. Singapore's mangroves collectively store more than 1.6 million tons of CO2. This is equivalent to the carbon emissions of 621,000 people. If Max and the mangroves aren't protected and die out, these superb carbon sinks and storers will become carbon producers. This will increase greenhouse gases, speed up global warming and climate change. Without Max and the mangroves, we will all suffer. While mangroves need careful nurturing by specialist scientists and conservationists, it doesn't mean we can't all help to protect them. Start by visiting some of Singapore's mangroves and getting to know mangroves and all the wonderful wildlife that live within these magnificent ecosystems. Make sure you take care not to disturb or damage them by staying on the official trails, not leaving trash behind, and looking but not touching. Volunteer to join citizen science monitoring programs or an organized cleanup. And most of all, tell everyone you know how important it is to match the